When the going is good, almost everybody does well. But when the going is not so good, the real strength of a nation then emerges. And I must say, with a sense of satisfaction, that at important occasions in the global economic history in the last few years, whenever challenging situations have emerged, whether it was 2001, it was 2008, or it's 2015-16, India certainly has displayed a great deal of resilience. India is no longer satisfied just being referred to as a sweet spot or a bright spot. Compared to how various economies world over are doing, we certainly appear to be doing better. But then obviously we are not satisfied even with our current levels of our performance, because we do believe India's potential is certainly to grow at a pace much higher than what we are growing today. We want much better infrastructure. In particular, we want much better rural infrastructure in India. We want globally competitive urban infrastructure. We want a very buoyant private sector. We want people to realize the full benefits of their investment. And it's only then that the buoyancy in the private sector really is going to pick up. And we want a banking sector which is extremely strong and which has the potential to support growth. We are able to bring back that optimum strength into our banking system. Our ability to attract investment and our ability to grow much faster certainly will be more evident. Thank you, Mrs. Bhattacharya, for your opening comments and for having facilitated this event. You did mention in your comments that India continues to be one of the fastest growing global economies, if not the fastest. And we do intend for the next few years to continue to retain that position. It's only then that our ability to pull out a large section of our population out of poverty will certainly increase. One of the greatest challenges before India was to re-establish the credibility of the Indian economy. And in order to establish the credibility of Indian economy, it was important that we not only reform, but we continue to reform only in one direction. Our decision making becomes faster. Policy changes and improvements, including structural reforms which are to take place, the pace of those reforms is consistent.